My name is Kyle Harder, and we're here at Rev Limit Customs. Rev Limit is a hot rod shop. We build custom vehicles, usually muscle cars and hot rods, but we can work on anything. We got four different areas. Sheet metal, we're the majority of the fabs done here. We've got mechanics, and then we also have auto body and paint. During COVID, work really slowed down in Colorado. That's right when Trevor was getting backed up and busy, so he asked for some help. So that's what brought me to Lubbock. I mean, it was just basically come in, try to organize, and see how fast we can get through these. With a smaller crew, we worked through probably half of the projects that were on site when I got here. In 2019, when I picked up Shapr3D, I also started learning a different CAD program at the same time. Shapr3D was way more intuitive. The main fabricator, Harrison, started using it about the same time I did. Then our other fabricator and our body guy have both picked up the app also. And with Harrison having Shapr, I'm able to send him the files. He can look at them, either make changes or get prepped for the following day. The ability to show Trevor, show the big boss, what we're planning on doing. This is gonna be a lot faster.
I'm Trevor Cook, started the shop in 2012, and just pretty much by myself, and we've just been rolling ever since. And I've dumped like all my everything I've ever made money-wise. Stuff that we were way behind on, we've gotten caught up on. Everyone goes through short of help and everything else, but Shapr's helped us like really speed the process up where we're not second guessing ourselves. This saves us from starting over all the time, which has helped me big time.
So my name is Harrison Brooks. I'm the lead fabricator here at Rev Limit Custom. It's kind of a really lean crew that we have. Shapr3D really sped up the fabrication process. User interface is so intuitive with the Apple Pencil and the iPad. It's a lot faster than it used to be with other programs or the old school way of cardboard and marker and a pair of scissors. It's just so user intuitive that I can pull up my iPad here in the fab shop, sitting in front of a project with my tape measure, measure it, draw it, send it to my plasma cutter, and I have that part and it's done and I can hold it up and that's it. Now that they have it to where I can install it on my MacBook, I can do much larger assemblies. I mean, if you would have told me we were doing this 3 years ago, I would have said you were crazy. There's no way I would have been CAD designing parts, sitting in my fab shop, and then having a done part, you know, within a couple hours.
Shapr also allows us to design bigger, wilder things, full suspensions, chassis. It saves us a lot of time in the shop. It's probably 40% faster overall. Especially on the little projects, it could be up to 50.
Man, the future's now.
Most recently, we've been working on a fender vent for a 78 Trans Am.
It's a rare car to begin with. So the idea is to take a classic car, but if it was built now with modern technology and modern processes too. So it'll be a really slick car with no gaps or seams or edges.
Updating the looks a little bit, still kind of a throwback to the original design, have a similar aesthetic, but punch it up a little bit for the modern times. The ability to have the form in the 3D space and build our product, whatever it may be, in this case, the fender vent, it really allows us to try a bunch of different designs quickly.
All of that thought process could already be executed before hands are ever on the car. So I can build the sheet metal assembly that gets welded into the fender, and then Kyle can come in with the 3D scanner, have the actual dimensions perfect, and then design around that. So when we do go to final machining process, printing process, we know that that part's gonna fit perfect. We sweat the little tiny details. And being able to sweat those little tiny details in a 3D space versus a physical space and spending the time and building it really helps.
Once we have a 3D printed prototype, I can bring the iPad out to the shop. We can bolt the prototype in place, kind of watch it move, see how it exists in that space, and make changes directly to the CAD file, real time on the shop floor. So we actually changed the shape of the hole in the fender and then built a new vent to fit within that, updating the looks a little bit. We often need to get approval by the client for the design before we are installing in their vehicle. Using Shapr3D allows us to either send the collaborate link where they can see it on their computer or phone, spin it around in 3D form.
So having a visual aid to show them the end product really helps everyone get on the same page.
There's been times before Shapr where we did a bunch of trial and error on something and it's like, redo something three times, you're losing money basically. And so like, now with Shapr, it's a done deal. Shapr3D has definitely increased productivity in the shop.
Without Shapr3D, we wouldn't even attempt something like this. There are other CAD programs out there, obviously, but to be fluent enough in that program to be able to make something like this would take a lot longer. With Shapr and how fast we were able to get in and actually start designing, that kind of opened the door for more projects. We've actually added two CNC machines, a CNC mill and a CNC lathe, that allow us to create metal versions of all these parts that we're designing in Shapr. With the CNC machines and Shapr3D, now the possibilities for what we can create are basically endless.
With the new machines, we're really wanting to just start pushing like our own product line and build our own things. And then also we're gonna have the capability of doing custom machining for other people and having Shapr3D, you know, get to more of like building our own stuff and designing some crazier things and making bigger, better things happen.
We're no longer relying on outside help. We can do design to production in-house just with our design team and our fabrication team. I think we'll be pretty unstoppable.